Hello students, in the previous class we solved few problems and also we gave an introduction about what is a dependent sequence. So where I already told that, so we have two types of message sequences we have. One is we have a dependent sequences as well as independent sequences. So independent sequences are the one which are called as memoryless sources, or I could call them as zero memoryless sources. That means the sequences, they do not have any memory. That means they are not going to depend on one another for the prediction of the succeeding symbols. So that is what it is related to your independent sequences. So coming to the dependent sequences, so they are called as system with memory because they are going to depend on the previous symbols for the prediction of the succeeding symbols. So now, and also we saw that how we are going to calculate the average information rate, or what we call as the entropy, with respect to independent sequences. So now let us see how we are going to model the symbols or model the sequences if we are considering dependent sequences. Dependent sequences are the one where they are going to depend on one another. For example, if we consider this letter or the word queen, so where you can see here, so the first letter is Q, where we already know that the next letter will be U only. That means the next predicted symbol is already known to us. That means Q is dependent on U. So that's why here these type of what the word I have considered, so they are the more frequently occurring, or the occurrence of the letter U is already known to us. That means the information present with respect to your dependent sequences will be less when compared to that of the information present with respect to an independent sequence. That means to say that more information will be present with respect to independent sequences rather than with respect to your dependent sequences. So now how we are going to model, or how we are going to calculate the entropy with respect to the dependent sequences? So we are going to use what we call as a Markov statistical model for calculating the entropy with respect to dependent sequences. So now how we are going to calculate the entropy as well as the average information rate is that, where this Markov model, it consists of some states. That means the states are represented by circles like this. And also if we have two states, that is state 1 and state 2, they are represented with respect to the circles. So this one represents the state 1 and this represents the state 2. So now if there is a transition from one state to the other state, so then they are indicated with respect to the transitions, and also whatever the symbol gets emitted when it makes a transition from one state to the other state, so they are represented by an arrow indicating that a symbol has been emitted when it makes a transition from the initial state to the next state. So where you can see here, the state 1 is making a transition to state 2, and also this state 1, it can also have its own transition. That means to say that, so it can remain in state 1 only, or it can make a transition from 1 to 2. So similarly, if we consider with respect to state 2, so it can either make a transition to itself, or it can make a transition from 2 to 1 state. So that means to model this Markov source, so we are going to consider the state diagram. So how we are going to represent a state diagram is with respect to the states. So where here we are considering for understanding of this topic, we are considering only two states. So the states can be n number of states. So here we have considered n is equal to 2. That means we have two states, that is state 1 and state 2. So the states are defined, or they are enclosed with respect to the circle, and the transitions which are taking place from one state to the other state, so they are indicated with respect to these transitions, that is with respect to the directed lines, we have marked their transitions, and also whatever the symbols gets emitted, they we have indicated by them by an arrow. So this is, and corresponding to the symbol what it get emitted when it makes a transition from one state to the other state, so it is also emitting some probability. So if A is the symbol which is been emitted when you make a transition from one state, that is first state, to the second state, so corresponding to that, let us consider it emits a probability of 3/4. So similarly, when it makes a transition from second state to the first state, so let us consider it, the probability what it gets emitted is 3/4. And if it makes a self transition to the one state, so let us consider it as 8/4. So similarly, with respect to the state 2, so I can write it as 1/2. So this is how we are going to represent a Markov model with respect to the state diagram for modeling or to calculate the entropy with respect to the dependent sequences. So as you can see, with respect to the state diagram, it is depending upon the previous states for the prediction of the next state. That means, consider the state 1. So state 1 is having two transitions here. One is an outgoing transition and another one is an incoming transition. So now we have some formulas here to calculate the entropy. So how we are going to calculate the entropy of the Markov source for dependent sequences? So entropy of dependent sequences, so where this is given by Hi is equal to summation of I is equal to 1 to n Pij log of 1 by Pij bits per message symbol. So this is the formula what we are going to use to represent or in order to calculate the entropy with respect to the states, that is individual state, where I means I represents in which state it is. For example, so here we have two states, so that means H1 is equal to, so then Pij means, so I and J represents the initial state, so I represents the initial state here and J represents the final after transition, what is the final state it is going to reach. So for example, so if I consider Ij, that is 1 to 2 transition, so then what is the probability it gets emitted? So here P12 means the probability what it's emitted is 3/4. So like this, each state will be having its own probability when it makes a transition from one state to the other state. So since we have two states here, we will be having H1 as well as we will be having the next state where we will be finding what is your H2. So once you find your Hi value, next we need to calculate what is the average entropy, that is what is your capital H. So where capital H is given by summation of I is equal to 1 to n Pi into Hi. So where this can be written as summation of I is equal to 1 to n Pi, and I can write this as J is equal to 1 to n. So where this can be J is equal to 1 to n. So what is Hi? Hi is nothing but it is Pij log of 1 by Pij. So this is the formula what we have. So now you have already calculated what is your states with respect to this one. So I can write the equation as, or I can write it as Pi means it is this probability P1. Then we have Pij log of 1 by Pij means it is your H1 state plus P2 into H2. So this is your total entropy what we are going to calculate, or I could say that what is the average entropy with respect to the states. So now once you calculate all the different states, so then you need to calculate at different stages what is your entropy. That means if here we have considered only the single state. So now if you are going to consider for the successive stages, that means for example if you are going to consider this particular state diagram for further G1 state, first stage, then we have G2, that is for the second stage, and this is G3 for the third stage. So now if you are going to consider the same states for the extension, so then you need to calculate G1, G2, G3 up to Gn. So in general what I can consider for Gn is equal to 1 by n summation of I is equal to 1 to n P of mi log of 1 by P of mi. So this is what we are going to find out for Gn. So where Gn represents, it is a monotonically decreasing function. That means as you are going to increase the stages, that is from G1 to Gn, the entropy has to get reduced. So that means here n represents in which state you are, whether you are in the first stage or you are in the second stage or in the third stage. So if n is equal to 1, then you are going to find G1. Then your n will be 1 by 1, so that remains the same. So similarly, if you are going to find for the second stage, then your n value will get changed to n is equal to 2. So similarly, if you go for the third one, then n will be equal to 3. So this is how we are going to model the sequence for an dependence so information sources. So now let us consider or let us solve a simple example for this particular Markov statistical model. So this is the state diagram what I have considered for modeling of this statistical model. So now this is the state diagram what they have given. So where we have considered three states, that is state 1 as well as state 2. So now we already know that first we need to calculate what are the entropy with respect to the individual state. That is, we need to calculate what is the individual state of the state 1 as well as state 2. So before that, we need to find what is the corresponding probability. That means we are going to, since we have two states, we will be having two probabilities. That is, we have P of 1 as well as P of 2. So now in order to calculate the first probability P of 1, so we are going to consider, so what is P of 1? So P of 1 is equal to, so it is 3 by 4 P of 1 plus, so we need to consider the incoming transition while we are going to calculate the probability. So it is 1 by 4 P of 2. So similarly, if we consider the probability with respect to the state 2, so P of 2 is equal to 3 by 4 P of 2 plus what is the incoming transition to the state 2? So it is 1 by 4 P of 1. So this is your equation 1 and this is your equation 2. So if we consider the equation 1, so then we will be getting 1 by 4 P of 1 is equal to 1 by 4 of P of 2. So this is your equation 3. So similarly, if we consider equation 2, so we will be getting 1 by 4 P of 2 is equal to 1 by 4 of P of 1. So that means, so from equation 3 as well as equation 4, what we can conclude? We can conclude that P of 1 is equal to P of 2. So when the probabilities will be equal, we know that the probabilities will be equal only when they are equiprobable. That means when they have the same probability. And also we have derived an equation with respect to this, how we are going to achieve the probabilities are equiprobable. So equiprobable in the sense its probability will be equal to only when P is equal to 0.5 we can achieve maximum entropy. So that's why I can consider p of 1 equals p of 2 is equal to 1 by 2. So that means p of 1 value as well as p of 2 value will be equal. That means to say that they are equiprobable. So now the first thing what you have to do while solving this particular state diagram is you need to first calculate what is the probability if the probabilities are not given. So if the probabilities are already given in the problem statement, so then you need not find out what is the probability. If the probabilities are not given, so then the very first thing what you need to do is this. You need to calculate what is the probability with respect to the individual states. So since we have only two states here, we have considered the probability as p of 1 and p of 2. If you have 4 or 5 probabilities, then you need to calculate all the 5 probabilities first, and then only you need to calculate the next entropy. So after finding the probability, so the next thing what you need to do is you need to find out what is the entropy with respect to the individual state. Individual state in the sense you are going to use the formula Hi is equal to summation of j equals 1 to n Pij log of 1 by Pij. So now I am considering the first state, that is H1. H1 means it is with respect to the first state. So H1 is equal to, so what is H1 is equal to? So with respect to H1, we are going to consider P11 log of 1 by P11 plus P12 log of 1 by P12. So what is P of 11 here? So P of 11 is 3 by 4. So 3 by 4 log of 4 by 3 plus P12. So it is 1 by 4 log of 4. So if you find out this, you will be getting what is your H1 state. So now remember, while solving the problem, that means while calculating the probability, you need to consider the incoming states to the state 1. But while calculating the entropy, you need to assume or you need to consider the probability which is going out from that particular state. So now for this state 1, I have considered the P11 state plus what is the transition it is making. That is the transition state I have considered here as P12, and what is the corresponding probability it is emitted? It is 1 by 4. So now if you calculate the value of this, you will be getting what is your H1 state. So similarly, next I need to calculate what is your H2 state. So H2 state is, once again, it is P22 log of 1 by P22 plus P21 log of 1 by P21. So now here P22 is what? P22 is nothing but it is, once again, it is 3 by 4 log of 4 by 3 plus 2 to 1 transition is 1 by 4. So it is 1 by 4 log of 1 by 4. So now if you calculate the value, you will be getting what is your H1 as well as H2. So now once you calculate the individual state's entropy, then you need to calculate what is the total entropy H, or I could see H total. H total is equal to P1 into H1 plus P2 into H2. So what is your P1? So we calculated what is your P1, that is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into H1. So H1 is the value what you are going to calculate here. So that you are going to substitute here, plus the probability is 1 by 2 into what is your H2 value what you have got here, that you need to substitute here, and you are going to calculate what is your total entropy, that is HT. So once you calculate what is your total entropy HT, so then what you need to calculate here is you need to calculate what are the different stages. That means you need to find the extension of this particular state diagram. So if you consider for the first one, so here I am going to consider individual states. So now let us consider with respect to the first state I am considering here. So if I consider the first state, what are the transitions I am having? I am having 1 to 1 transition and then I am having 1 to 2 transition. So I have 1 to 1 and 1 to 2. So what is the probability with respect to state 1? P of 1 is 1 by 2. So when it makes a transition from 1 to 1, so what is the probability it is emitting? So 1 to 1 means it is, the probability emitted is 3 by 4. And what is the symbol? It is A. So similarly, if I consider with respect to the transition from 1 to 2, so 1 to 2 means it is, the probability emitted is 1 by 4 and the symbol what it is emitting is C. So this is with respect to what? This is with respect to the initial state, that is only for G is equal to 1, I am going to get this one. So now if I want to go for the next extension, that is for the second extension. So then I am going to extend with respect to this particular state now. From one state, what are the two transitions I can have? I can have one is 1 to 1 and another one is 1 to 2. So now what are the probabilities it is emitting? It is 3 by 4 and here it is 1 to 2 means it is 1 by 4 and so this is A and this is C. So now I need to consider with respect to state 2, that means from state 2 what are the two transitions I am having. So from state 2 I can have one is 2 to 1, another one is I can have 2 to 2 transition. So with respect to 2 to 1 I am having, so 2 to 1 it is 1 by 4 and the symbol emitted is C, and with respect to 2 to 2 so the probability it is emitted is 3 by 4 and the symbol it is emitting is B. So this is for with respect to, so this whole thing what I have considered. So up to here. So this is for the G1 state. And now I need to consider for the G, if you want to consider for G2 state, so then you need to consider up to here the G2 state. So this is your G2. So now if further I want to calculate for the third extension. So now let us consider in this example, I need to calculate what is my G1, what is my G2 and what is my G3. So now here, in order to calculate your G3, so now further I need to extend this source symbols. So I need to make an extension of this. So one can have two transition, one is 1 to 2 and another one is 1 to 2. So 1 to 1, it is 3 by 4 and the symbol emitted is A. And with respect to 1 to 2, I can have the probability 1 by 4 and the symbol emitted is C. So similarly with respect to 2, I can have two transition. So one is 2 to 1 and the one is 2 to 2. So 2 to 1, I can have 1 by 4 and the symbol is C. And here it is 3 by 4 and the symbol emitted is B. So now here, once again, it is 1 to 1, 1 to 2. So here it is 2 to 1 and 2 to 2. So here 1 to 1 means it is once again 3 by 4 and the symbol emitted is A, and 1 to 2 means it is C and the probability is 1 by 4. So with respect to 2 to 1 we have the symbol emitted is C and the probability is 1 by 4, and 2 to 2 once again it is 3 by 4 with the symbol emitted is B. So this is with respect to your G3. So this is how you are going to extend the Markov source, where you can see here when it goes for the second stage, it is depending upon the previous symbols. So similarly when it goes for the third stage, so it is going to depend upon the second, first as well as the initial state. So this is, that's why we call them as the dependent sequences. That means the system with memory. Okay, similarly now let us consider the second state. So that is with respect to the second state, we can have a transition from one is 2 to 1 and the one is 2 to 2. So when it emits 2 to 1, so we have 1 by 4 with C and this is B with 3 by 4. And what is the probability with respect to state 2? The probability is 1 by 2. So now here, once again, if we extend for the second extension, so this can have 1 to 1, 1 to 2, and this will be having 2 to 1 and 2 to 2. So this will be 1 by 4, C, and this is 3 by 4, B. This is 1 to 1, so we have 3 by 4 with symbol A, and 1 to 2 it is 1 by 4. With the symbol emitted is C. So now, so this is for your G1 state and this is for your G2 state. So now I also need to find the extension for the third stage. So further I need to extend this one. So this can have 1 to 1 transition, this can have 1 to 2. So this can have 1 to 1, 2 to 2. So similarly, 1 to 1, 1 to 2, so this is 2 to 1, this is 2 to 2, so this is 3 by 4, A, this is 1 by 4, C, so this is 1 by 4 with C, and this is 3 by 4 with B, this is 3 by 4, A, and this is 1 by 4 with C. This is 1 by 4 with C and this is 3 by 4 with B. So this ends with respect to the third extension, that is your G3 state. So this is how you are going to represent the Markov model if they asked you to find what are the values of G1, G2 and G3. Where in the problem they might ask you only to find G1 or G2. So the finally what they are going to ask is maximum up to G3 state they can ask you. So this is how you are going to split the Markov statistical model for third stages. So this is for G1 stage, G2, G3. So where this is the initial state and this is your first stage, second, third one. So you can club together the first and the second state and you can write it in a single state diagram. But here, in order to make you all clearly understand, so I have splitted the two states individually and I have shown you the split up with respect to all the successive three stages. So now once you find all the splitting up of these symbols, so next you need to find what is your G1. So now in order to find G1, so you need to calculate what are the corresponding probabilities you have. So if you consider with respect to the first stage, that is with respect to G1, so I can have only the probability that is PA, I can have PB as well as what is the probability P of A, P of B as well as P of C. So what is P of A? So P of A means it is you have 1 to 1 transition. So where I can write P of A is equal to, so P of A is equal to, I can write it as 1 by 2 into 3 by 4. And also here, when you need to find your P of B, so here you don't have from the initial state to the second stage where you have a transition, you have only P of A. So you have P of C here, but you don't have P of B. If you come to the second state diagram, so where you can see we have P of B here. So that's why I can write P of B is equal to 1 by 2 into 3 by 4. So it will be 3 by 8 and this is also will be 3 by 8. Now in order to calculate your P of C, so P of C is present in the state 1 also and we also have with respect to the state 2. So then P of C is written as, or we are going to calculate the P of C as 1 by 2 into 1 by 4 plus we also need to consider in this state what is P of C value, that is 1 by 2 into 1 by 4. So it will be 1/8 + 1/8, which is equal to 2/8, which is nothing but you will be getting 1/4. So this is how you are going to calculate the probabilities with respect to G1. So now you have calculated what is your P of A, P of B and P of C. Now you need to calculate what is your G1 value. So what is G1 now? So G1 is equal to, so we have the formula 1/n. So what is n here? N is equal to 1 because we are considering the first stage. So when n is equal to 1, it is 1/1. So it is 1 only. So after that we have in the formula P of mi is nothing but the probabilities. So P of mi means it is 3/8 log of 8/3. So since we have the probabilities repeated, I can just write into 2 plus P of C, that is 1/4 log 4. So if you calculate this, you will be getting what is your G1 value. So now I need to find what is your G2 value. So G2 is equal to, so what are the possibilities we have with respect to the second stage? So second stage means what we need to consider? We need to consider up to here. So we have A into A, that means we have the first probability P of AA is equal to, what is P of AA is equal to? We need to consider the initial state probability. It is 1/4 × 3/4 × 3/4. So this is A into A. So we have 1/2 × 3/4 × 3/4. So it is 9/32. So this is of P of A into A. So what are the other possibilities we have? P of A into C. So it is P of AC. So P of AC is equal to 1/2 × 3/4 × 1/4. So it is 3/32. So similarly, what is the next probability we have? We have C into C. C. So we have C into C, which is equal to 1/2 × 1/4 × 1/4. So it is 1/32. So next we have P of C into B. So P of C into B means it is 1/2 × 1/4 × 3/4. So it is 3/32. So now this is with respect to state 1. So similarly we need to consider with respect to state 2. So it is C into A. So it is C into C, next we have B into C, and we have B into B. So we have CA is equal to 1/2 × 1/4 × 3/4, this 3/32. Then we have P of C into C, which is equal to 1/2 × 1/4 × 1/4, which is equal to 1/32. Then next we have PBC. So P of BC is equal to 1/2 × 1/4 × 3/4. So it will be 3/32. Next we have P of B into B. So that will be equal to 1/2 × 3/4 × 3/4. So it is 9/32. So these are the probabilities what we are going to get by considering both the states for stage 2, that is for G2. So now how many probabilities we have? We have 8 probabilities. Now you need to calculate what is your G2. So G2 is equal to, what is n here? N is 2. So 1/2 Now consider all the probabilities here. So we have P of, so one more thing what you need to consider here is, so you have to look into here which are the probabilities which are common. So as you can see here, we have P of CC and P of CC. These are the two common probabilities what we have. So we can club together, that means you can add together P of CC, and then you can consider only a single probability with respect to P of CC. So here we have P of AA, so it is 9 by 32 log of 32 by 9 plus 3 by 32 log of 32 by 3. So how many 3 by 32 log 3 32 log, that is log, how many probabilities are there with respect to 3 by 32? We have 1, 2, 3 and 4. So you can multiply by 4. Plus, next is we have P of CC. So it is 1 by 32 plus 1 by 32. So we have 2 P of CC which is common. So it is 1 by 32 plus 1 by 32. So where it will be, where we will be having 2 by 32, which is nothing but 1 by 16. So that means I need to consider only one probability, that is 1 by 16 log of 16 plus. Then we have 1 by 32, 1, and here. So we have 2 1 by 32, so I can club them together. So 1 by 32 log of 32 multiplied by 2. So now if you calculate this whole value, you are going to get what is your G2. So next you are going to calculate what is your G3 state, that is your third stage. So now in order to calculate your G3, so first you need to calculate what are the probabilities. So the probabilities, in the sense here, you are going to consider with respect to state 1, it is A triple A. And here you are going to consider AAC. And for this it is ACC. And for this it is ACB. And for this it is CCA. And this is triple C. And this is CBC. And this is CB and B. So first probability is AAA. So AAA's initial state is 1 by 2 multiplied by 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 3 by 4. So it is 27. So it is 16 4 is 64. So 64 into 2. So it is 128. So similarly, you need to calculate what is your PAAC. So it is 1 by 2 into 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4. So it is 9 by 128. And next you have PACC. So initial state is 1 by 2. Then into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4 into 1 by 4. So it is 1 by 2 into 1 by 4 into 3 by 4, 1 by 4 into 1 by 4. So it is 3 by 128. So next is P of ACB. So P of ACB is 1 by 2 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4 into 3 by 4. So it is 9 by 128. So next we have P of CCA. So which is 1 by 2 into 3 by 4. 1 by 4, 1 by 4 into 1 by 4 into 3 by 4. So it is 3 by 128. So then we have P of C triple C. So P of triple C is 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into 1 by 4 into 1 by 4. So it is 1 by 128. So next we have P of CBC. So it is 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4. So it is 3 by 128. Then similarly we have P of CBB. So it is 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 3 by 4 into 3 by 4. So which is equal to 9 by 128. So these are the values what you are going to get if you consider only the state 1. So similarly you need to calculate here what is with respect to state 2. So it is CAA, so it is CAC, and this is triple C, and we have CCB, and here we have BCA, and here we have BCC, and here it is BBC, and here we have triple B. So now once again you need to write what are the values of the probabilities, that is PCAA. So PCAA is 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 3 by 4. So it is 9 by 128. So similarly you need to find what is CAC. So CAC is 1 by 2 into 1 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4. So it is 3 by 128. Then we have triple C. So triple C is 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into 1 by 4 into 1 by 4, so it is 1 by 128. Then we have P of CCB, so CCB is 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into 1 by 4 into 3 by 4, so it is 3 by 128. Then we have P of BCCC, so BCA. So BCA is 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 1 by 4 into 3 by 4, so it is 9 by 128. Then we have BCCC, so BCC is 1 by 2 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4 into 1 by 4, so it is 3 by 128. Then we have P of BBC. So P of BBC is 1 by 2, 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 1 by 4. So it is 9 by 128. So similarly, we have one more probability. I'm going to write it here. So it is PBB, triple B. So it is 1 by 2 multiplied by 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 3 by 4. So it is 27 divided by 128. So this is how you are going to write all the probabilities with respect to the third stage. So now here you need to find once again whether we have any common probabilities. So AAA we don't have any other common thing. So only one AAA we have, and similarly with respect to AAC, then ACC, that also we don't have. So the only common common probability what we are going to get is only P triple C and one more P triple C here. So it is 1 by 128, and similarly that is also 1 by 128. It is P triple C. So 1 by 128 plus 1 by 128. So you will be getting 2 by 128. So it is 1 by 64. So the probability of P triple C is 1 by 64. So next you need to find what G3 state. So now G3 is given by G3 is equal to 1 by n. So since the we are considering here the third stage, so n will be equal to 3, so that's why it is G3. 1 by n means it is 1 by 3. Then what is probability of P triple A? So it is 27 by 128 log of 128 divided by 27. So now let us look into what are the probabilities with respect to the same probability, that is 27 by 128, how many number of 27 by 128 we have. So we have only one triple, so we have only one 27 by, oh okay, we have two 27 by 128, so it is into 2 plus 9 by 128, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we have 9 by 128 log of 128 by 9 into 6 plus, next we are going to see for 3 by 128 it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So we have 3 by 128 log of 128 by 3 into 6 plus how many number of 1 by 128? We have 1, 1 by 128, then we have 2, so only we have 2 1 by 128, so it is 1 by 128 log of 128 plus we have 1 by 64, so it is 1 by 64 log of 64. So if you calculate this, you will be getting what is your G3 value. So that means always in general, so as I already told that when you go for this, you know, number of stages, so your entropy has to get reduced. So that means your G1 value should be greater than G2 and it should be greater than G3. So this you need to remember. So while you are going to solve the Markov statistical model problems, so by verify or by looking at this G1, G2, G3 values, what you have found out, you can verify whether you have done correctly or not.